In this class, we'll see how to obtain the trigonometric Fourier series for off-wave rectified sine signal. So this is the output of the off-wave rectified signal, where you will be having only positive off cycle. For the negative off cycle, we will have the zero value. So now, first of all, before writing the trigonometric Fourier series, we have to write the mathematical expression for this signal x of t. Okay. Again, this is something similar to full sine wave, but we are not having any value for the negative off cycle. In the negative off cycle, we are having zero. So the expression for this is something similar to the original sine signal. Okay, then what is the original sine signal? Okay, if it is the original sine signal, again, what is the time period? Or otherwise, even here also, the time period is 2 pi. Time period is 2 pi. Again, already we know that the frequency of this signal is omega is equal to 2 pi divided by t. Again, in this case, the time period is 2 pi, again 1. So the frequency of this signal is 1 radian per second. So then what is the mathematical expression? In general, the signal we used to call like this, x of t is equal to amplitude of the signal. Here, the amplitude of the signal is already given as Vm. Okay, so Vm sine omega t, where omega is 1. Okay, in general, Vm sine omega t, where the omega value is 1, Vm sine omega t. Okay, again, this Vm sine omega t is valid in between 0 to pi. Okay, so this is valid in between 0 to pi. When you are outside 0 to pi, that means when you are from pi to 2 pi, the signal value is 0. Okay, so this is the mathematical expression of the half-wave rectified signal. Then what is the average value? A naught. Again, definitely it will have some average value. Already we have calculated in the other example also. Again, similar problem already we have represented in terms of exponential Fourier series coefficient. So that time also we have calculated C naught. Again, C naught and A naught is in general same. So what is A naught for this one? A naught is equal to 1 by t integration 0 to t x of t dt. Okay, that is the area under this. Divided by the total time, that is what is average over the full time period, that is 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so 1 by time period is 2 pi, integral 0 to 2 pi, again signal x of t dt, again 1 by 2 pi. Integral 0 to pi, only from 0 to pi signal is defined, that is Vm sine t. When the limit goes from pi to 2 pi, the value is 0, so 0 dt. Okay, then what is the integration value? The integration of sine t is equal to minus cos t. Again, limit varies from pi to 0. So now Vm divided by 2 pi cos pi minus cos 0. Cos pi means minus 1. So overall final value is Vm divided by pi. Okay, so already we have derived it. So okay, A naught. A naught is something similar to C naught. That is in general Vm divided by pi. That is the average value of the half-wave rectifier output is Vm divided by pi, average value or DC value, average or DC value of the off-wave rectified output is Vm divided by pi. So next, what is An? Okay, An, and then what is Bn? An and Bn we have to calculate. Again, if you see this signal, okay, what about the nature of this signal? This signal is neither even nor odd signal, okay, but if you just shift the signal by the amount of pi by 2, okay, see, again, before calculating this one, we'll have some intuitive idea. See, the signal is given like this. 0 to pi, 2 pi. Okay. So suppose if you shift the signal either by left or right by the factor of pi by 2, okay, by the factor of pi by 2, either left or right, no problem, then you will be getting the signal like this. You will be getting the signal like this. Okay, this is the original signal. This is the signal shifted by the factor of pi by 2. This is the signal shifted by the factor of pi by 2. So that means what? The original signal is neither even nor odd signal. This is neither even nor odd signal. But whereas the shifted version of the signal, is even signal. Okay, even signal. Okay, so that means what? This is something similar to, if you apply some operation, the signal is behaving like an even signal. Okay, I'm not applying any operation on amplitude, only I'm just adjusting in the time. So I'm getting even signal nature. So this is something almost similar to even signal. Okay, so this signal, original signal, is something similar to even signal if you apply some operation. So that's why we'll get the properties of even signal, but we'll get some extra content due to this shifting operation. So we know that whenever we are having even signal, okay, so definitely we will have an term. Okay, in general, if it is purely even signal, only we will get an term and a naught term, bn will be zero, but this is not purely even signal. Okay, so this is the shifted version. Okay, this signal is the, once if you shift the original signal, then you will get the even signal. So that's why for this signal, x of t definitely will get an. Anyway, already a naught will be there once if it is of even nature. But because of this shifting operation, you will get some component, only some component of b. So some component of bn. Okay, not all the component of bn, only some component of bn. Okay, if it is originally even signal, we'll get only an, a naught, definitely bn is zero. But here, because of the shifting operation, we'll get some component of bn. Okay, some component of bn. Okay, the next, how to find out the an? An is equal to 2 divided by t integration 0 to t x of t cos n omega naught t dt. Now the question here is, what is the value of omega naught? Omega naught is the fundamental frequency. Okay, again, please get the clarification between these two. Here the omega is the frequency of this signal, whereas here omega naught is the fundamental frequency of the signal that you are going to introduce in the Fourier series. Okay, formula, Fourier series equations. Okay, so that means what? Again, you should know the difference between omega and omega naught. Okay, so see, if the signal is given like this, okay, it is given like this. Now, what we are going to do? We are going to represent in terms of the periodic signal, many periodic signal, sinusoidal signal. So that time, definitely, we'll introduce some sinusoidal signal like this. Okay, first signal like this. Okay, so it goes like this. Then second signal also we'll introduce. Okay, so during the second signal, what will happen? Again, here itself we'll complete one cycle. Okay, so you see, if you see carefully here we are having two cycle. So next we'll have four cycle. next you will have 4 cyclic. It goes like that. So that means what? The whatever the omega that we are writing, that is denoting the original non-sinusoidal periodic signal, whatever the omega naught that we are writing, it is representing the periodic sinusoidal signal frequency. Okay, this we are introducing. So this is omega naught, means next one is 2 omega naught. So but in most of the cases, omega is equal to omega naught. 99% of the time for the problem, omega is equal to omega naught only, because here also the period is from here to here only. For this signal is also, for the fundamental base signal is also, the period is from this only. So that's why the omega and omega naught is same in most of the problem. Okay, even if it is same here, but it will not be same in few cases. Okay, that will come to that. We'll come to that later. Okay, so just to try to understand the difference between omega and omega naught. Omega is the original signal given in the question. Okay, omega naught is the signal that you are introducing. Okay, that you are introducing. So finally, we'll add all the signal. Okay, we'll represent many signal, infinite signal. Then we will add. So finally, we will get this signal. Okay, original signal. That is the idea of the Fourier series. So in this case, omega and omega naught is same. Okay, so then what is omega naught value? Omega naught value is also 1, because omega and omega naught is same here. So that's why omega is 1. So definitely omega naught is also 1. Okay. So then we proceed further. An is equal to 2 divided by t. T is 2 pi. Again, the limit from 0 to pi, Vm sine t. Okay, Vm sine t cos n omega naught t. Omega naught value is 1. Okay, so cos n t integral pi to 2 pi, value of the signal is 0, cos n t dt. Okay, so definitely the second integral value is 0. Okay, then this Vm we can take out, Vm divided by pi. Integration of 0 to pi sin t cos n t dt. Okay, so what is this integration value? This is integration of sin theta and cos theta. So we know that sin a cos b, again this is t, this is n t. So that's why sin a cos b is equal to sin a plus b plus sin a minus b divided by 2. Okay, so Vm divided by pi is equal to 0 to pi sin 1 plus nt sin 1 plus n into t plus sin 1 minus n into t divided by 2 into dt. Again, integration of sin 1 plus nt is sin 1 plus nt, integration of sin is cos minus cos 1 plus nt divided by 1 plus n. Again, integration of sin 1 minus n is minus cos 1 minus nt divided by 1 minus n. So just apply the integration individually. So this is Vm divided by pi. Minus cos 1 plus n t divided by 1 plus n. Okay, these two we can take out. Again, minus cos 1 minus n t divided by 1 minus n. Limit is from 0 to pi. Just you apply the limit. Vm divided by 2 pi minus cos 1 plus n pi divided by 1 plus n minus cos 1 minus n pi divided by 1 minus n plus cos 0. Okay, what is cos 0 value? 1. Cos 0 value is 1. So 1 plus n, again cos 0 value is 1 divided by 1 minus n. Okay, now what is the value of cos 1 plus n pi? Okay, so we know that cos of pi is minus 1. Okay, so again cos of 2 pi is plus 1. So that's why whenever cos n pi is there, we used to write minus 1 whole power n. Whenever n is odd, we'll get minus 1. Whenever n is even, we'll get plus 1. So same thing we can extend here. Instead of cos n pi, we are having n plus 1 or 1 plus n into pi. So that means I can simply write minus 1 whole power instead of n, I can write minus 1 whole power 1 plus n. So if you apply this properly, okay, Vm divided by 2 pi, Vm divided by 2 pi. Already minus is there, Again, I am getting minus 1 whole power 1 plus n divided by 1 plus n. Already minus is there. Minus 1 whole power 1 minus n divided by 1 minus n. Again, this is 1 by 1 plus n, 1 by 1 minus n. Okay, now, we take this equation, then we'll analyze. Okay. So, what happens when you put n as a odd values? Okay, so we'll first put n as a odd value. Okay. If n is odd, just we'll see what happens. If n is odd, 1 plus odd is even, minus 1 whole power even number is plus 1. Already minus is there, so minus 1 divided by 1 plus n. Here if you put n as a odd, again 1 minus odd is even, then minus 1 whole power even is plus 1. Already minus is there. So minus 1 divided by 1 minus n. Again, this is 1 plus n and 1 plus 1 minus n. Okay, so see here, minus 1 by 1 plus n. This is plus 1 by n plus 1. Again, this is minus. This is plus. So finally 0. So that means in this expression, if you substitute n as a odd number, definitely the an value, so this is an, the an is 0. So one thing is very clear here, an is 0 when n is odd, when n is odd. Then what happens when n is even? So next, if n is even, what happens to an? If n is even, what happens to an? So once if you put n as a even, again 1 plus n is odd, minus 1 whole power odd number is minus 1, already minus is there. So this is plus 1 by 1 plus n. So this is plus 1 by 1 plus n. Again, similarly, if you apply here also you will be getting plus 1 by 1 minus n. Plus 1 by 1 minus n. Again, already these things we can write directly. Plus 1 by 1 plus n plus 1 by 1 minus n. So again, if you further simplify, again we have to write this term Vm divided by 2 pi. Vm divided by 2 pi. If you simplify further, Vm divided by 2 pi, 2 divided by 1 plus n, 2 divided by 1 minus n. Vm divided by 2 pi, 2 minus 2n, 2 plus 2n. Again, a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square, 1 minus n square. 1 minus n square. Vm divided by 2 pi, 4 divided by 1 minus n square, in Vm, 2 Vm divided by pi, 1 minus n square. When an is equal to 2 Vm divided by pi into 1 minus n square, when n is equal to even, when n is even number. So again, in this expression, if you see 1 minus n square is there, whenever you put n is equal to 1, again, this expression is not valid. It will become like infinite. But again, we don't need to worry about that because we cannot put n is equal to 1 because n is equal to 1 is the odd number. But for odd number, already we have an is equal to 0. So that's why again, we are not having any confusion. So clearly, an is 2vm divided by pi into 1 minus n square. Okay. So then next we'll try to find out what is bn calculation. So bn is equal to 2 divided by t integral 0 to t x of t sine n omega naught t dt 2 divided by 2 pi integral 0 to pi what is x of t vm sine t. Again, omega naught value is 1. This is sine nt dt. This is sine A, sine B formula. So sine A, sine B is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B divided by 2. Okay, then 1 by pi. What about the other integral actually here? The other integral goes from pi to 2 pi, but the value of the signal is 0 there. Okay. Sine nt dt. Okay, so the 1 by pi, 1 by pi, 0 to pi. Vm and this we can write cos A minus B. Again, whenever cos is there, we can write A minus B or B minus A, both are okay because cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. So cos of 1 minus n, or you can also write n minus 1. Okay, cos of 1 minus n t minus cos 1 plus n into t divided by 2 into dt. This Vm we can take out. Okay, Vm and pi is there. This 2 also we can take out. Okay, Vm divided by 2 pi. Then what is the integration of cos theta? That is sine 1 minus n t divided by 1 minus n minus sine 1 plus n divided by 1 plus n whole power pi 0. The limit is from 0 to pi. Okay, then apply the limit bn is equal to vm divided by 2 pi sine 1 minus n pi by 1 minus n minus sine 1 plus n into pi divided by 1 plus n sine 0 plus sine 0. Vm divided by 2 pi sine pi. Okay, sine pi is always 0. Okay, even whatever may be the number. Okay, let it be even or odd. This is always 0. Similarly, this is also 0, 0, 0. So this is all finally this is 0. But one thing here is this is valid. Bn is equal to 0 is valid only when n is not equal to 0. See, Bn is equal to 0 is valid when n not equal to 1, when n is not equal to 1. Because when you substitute n is equal to 1 here, all these expressions are okay. But here, you'll get 0 by 0. But 0 by 0 is not allowed. So that means what? Bn is 0 is allowed only when n is not equal to 1. So, but specifically we have to find out when n is equal to 1, what is the value of bn? When n is equal to 1, what is the value of bn? Okay, that we have to find out. So bn is in general 0, except at n is equal to 1. But at n is equal to 1, what is happening? We have to find out. Okay, we have to find out. Okay, so then what is the general expression of bn? Again, we are going to calculate B1. Okay, we want to calculate B1. Then how can we calculate limit n tends to 1 bn. Already we are having the expression for bn. If you want to calculate b1, limit n tends to 1 bn. Okay, so limit n tends to 1. What is the value of bn? Bn is vm divided by 2 pi sine 1 minus n into pi divided by 1 minus n, and then sine 1 plus n pi divided by 1 plus n. Okay, so then if you apply n is equal to 1 here, again the second term, okay, if you apply n is equal to 1, the second term is 0, clearly no problem, it is 0, because when you apply n is equal to 1, again we'll see what happens. When you apply n is equal to 1, this is, yes, this is bn only, because we are calculating b1 here, okay, yes, bn. Okay, then just apply n is equal to 1. So then b1 will get b1 is equal to vm divided by 2 pi sine, okay, sine 0 divided by 0, okay, sine 2 pi divided by 2. Okay, so vm divided by 2 pi 0 by 0, this is 0 by 2. Okay, so if you notice here, this term is not allowed, 0 by 0 is not allowed. So if this is not allowed, again we have to specifically calculate what is this limit value. Okay, anyway, this is producing 0 only, the second term is producing 0. So we have to specifically find out what is this term. Okay, so finally n, finally b1 is equal to limit n tends to 1 vm divided by 2 pi sine 1 minus n pi divided by 1 minus 1. So once if we get 0 by 0, we can apply the L'Hospital rule. So that is vm divided by 2 pi, just the differentiation in both the numerator and denominator separately. Okay, vm by 2 pi we can take out, limit n tends to 1, apply the L'Hospital rule, differentiation of the numerator is cos 1 minus n pi. Again, please make sure that differentiation with respect to what? Differentiation with respect to n, because n is limit, so differentiation with respect to n. So once if you do differentiation with respect to n, cos of 1 minus n pi, again we'll get minus pi extra divided by 1 minus 1. Again, you differentiate 1 minus 1, you'll get minus 1. Then vm divided by 2 pi, if you apply the limit now, cos of 0 is 1, okay, and this is separate term, okay, cos of 0 is 1, already minus pi divided by minus 1, so pi is the answer, pi cancel, you will be getting vm divided by 2. So ultimately what you are getting, b1 is equal to vm divided by 2, vm divided by 2. So that means what? Bn is equal to 0, valid when n not equal to 1. Okay, when n is other than 1, bn is 0. But when n is equal to 1, you are getting vm by 2. Okay, or otherwise, if you are having confusion in this method, okay, we can also find out b1 directly from here also. Okay, see, bn means b1. So in this expression itself, put n is equal to 1. Okay, when you put n is equal to 1, this is sine t, sine t. Okay, sine square theta. Again, sine square theta, you can represent in terms of what? Cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Similarly, sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. So, again, you can apply that trigonometric identity. From this also, you can directly get the answer without applying the L'Hospital rule. L'Hospital rule. Okay, that is also possible. So finally, what is the Fourier series representation? X of t is equal to a naught summation n 1 to infinite a n cos n omega naught t plus b n sine n omega naught t. What is a naught value? Vm divided by pi. A naught value is vm divided by pi. what is again an is defined only for even number. Okay, whenever for an, if n is odd, the value is zero, so that's why this is only defined for even number. So 0 to 4 up to infinite. What is that an? 2 vm divided by pi 1 minus n square. Okay, in some book they will take this minus outside, so they will put n square minus 1. That minus will be available here, that is also possible. Okay, then what about this one? Okay, so this we can write separately. Okay, summation, again these terms separately, summation n 1 to infinite bn sin n omega naught t. But what is happening there? But this bn is zero always except at n is equal to 1. So that means you just represent b1. Okay, what is that b1 value? Again, before representing that, you write this cos n omega naught t. Again, we know what is omega naught. Okay, omega naught is 1. So we can simply write cos n t. Okay, then next, what is b1? B1 is vm by 2 sin n omega naught t. Already omega naught value is 1. Again, you are representing only b1. Again, instead of n, you supply 1. So this is vm by 2 sin t. Vm by 2 sin t. So this is the final answer. Okay, please note down here. This is separate term. This is separate term. This is separate term. Okay, so in this expression, we are having a naught. We are having an. We are having some part of bn. That is only one part of bn. That is b1. Okay, that only I told you in the beginning. Okay. So the given signal is something similar to even signal, but not exactly even signal. But if you apply some operation, we'll get the even signal. Okay, so equivalent to this operation, we are getting some component of bn, that is b1. Next, obtain the trigonometric Fourier series for the full wave rectified signal. Full wave rectified sine wave. First of all, we should know how to write the mathematical expression for the full wave rectified signal. For that, I will take the general full wave rectified signal like this. Say, for example, if the signal is given like this. Okay, t, this is x of t. This is vm value. So 0t, 2t, 3t. What is the mathematical expression for this one? Okay, so far we are having a signal that is completing one cycle, one complete cycle, both positive and negative. But here we are completing only one cycle, that itself we are repeating. So that's why this mathematical expression for this one is little bit different from other signal. Okay, so first of all, you understand what is omega. Omega in general we used to write 2 pi divided by t. Okay, so that means what? Phase. Okay, that means what? Phase change with respect to time change. Okay, so that is the concept of omega. Omega means phase change with respect to time change. That means when you travel t time, definitely you will attain 2 pi phase. This is true for other signal, not for this signal. See, whenever you have a signal like this, okay, so this will be the time period. When you complete one time period, you will complete 2 pi phase. So that's why in general, we used to write omega is equal to 2 pi divided by t. So, but please understand what is omega. Omega means what is the phase change with respect to time change? What is the phase change with respect to time change? But here, this problem, in this problem, what is the time period? That is very clear. The time period is t. The time period of this problem is, this signal is t. Because with t, with the t, it is getting repeated. So the time period of this signal is simply t. But when you complete t, when you complete time period of t here, see, I'm writing separately. This is general formula. But for omega, for full wave rectifier, omega for full wave rectifier, this is what is happening here. When you complete time period of t, how much phase you are getting? You are going from here to here, then again you are reaching here. That means how much phase you are getting? Only pi phase. So that's why the omega for this signal is pi by t, but not 2 pi by t. Okay, you have to be very clear here. Okay, so omega is pi by t. Then once we know omega, again we can easily write what is the general signal format sine omega t. For this signal, we know what is omega. So again, this is a sine omega value is pi by t into small t. That's it. Okay, so this is the mathematical representation of the full wave rectifier signal. Mathematical representation of the full wave rectifier signal. Okay, this is very important. Already it is given as the assignment. Already it is given in the assignment. Okay, what is the mathematical representation of the full wave rectifier signal? So the same concept we'll use. Okay, in our case, again, this is the maximum amplitude of the signal. So now, what is the mathematical expression? X of t is equal to Vm sine omega t. Just now we have calculated what is omega. Vm is equal to sine pi by t into t. What is t? In this case, t time period itself is pi. So pi by pi cancel. So Vm sin t. So Vm sin t is the mathematical expression, mathematical representation of the given signal, given full wave rectifier signal. Okay. Again, rest of the process is very simple. Once if you write the mathematical expression, again calculating a naught, a one, a naught, a n, b n is very simple. Okay. So Vm sin t. Then one more problem here is, what is omega naught? See, here omega is 1, but what is omega naught? Okay, there we will have some confusion. Again, already I told you, omega and omega naught is in general same. What is omega? Omega is the frequency of the given signal. Omega naught is the frequency of the signal that you are using in the representation. Okay, see, let's okay, so the given signal is this one, full wave rectifier signal. Okay, now we are going to represent in terms of the sinusoidal signal, addition of infinite sinusoidal signal. Then what is the first signal that you will use for the representation? Very clearly, you see, this is 0 to t. So within 0 to t, you will use one cycle. So that means the basic signal that you will be using for the representation is this one. Okay, this is the basic signal that you will be using in your representation, say omega naught. Okay, already omega, we know what is omega, this one. This is omega. For this signal, frequency is omega that we have calculated, that is one. For this signal, what is omega naught? See, please be careful here. Within one cycle, within 0 to t, within one time period of the original non-sinusoidal periodic signal, you will have one cycle. So far, we are having omega and omega naught as same, but here it will be different. Here it will be different. Okay, so the very basic signal itself we'll be using like this. Then what is the next signal we'll use in the addition? We'll use the within this year we'll complete two cycles. Okay, here we are completing two, here we complete four. So in the given time period T, we'll complete one cycle. So this is omega naught. Now what is omega naught? Omega naught is 2 pi. In general, for this signal, omega naught is 2 pi divided by T, because again, this is time is same within one time period, but you are completing 2 pi phase. Okay, so 2 pi by T, again T is given as pi. Okay, 2 pi by pi, that is 2. That means what is your omega naught? 2. But whereas what is your omega? 1. So in this problem alone, your omega and omega naught will be really different. Okay, this is again very, very important. Okay, omega is 1, but whereas omega naught is 2. In most of the problem, omega and omega naught will be same, but only in this problem it will be different. This is the main reason why you are getting very different value for omega and omega naught. So in the book they mentioned some formula. Okay, they have given some formula. Finally, they got omega is equal to 1 or omega naught is equal to 2, or even in some material they mentioned like that. But this is the real reason behind why you are getting omega as 1, omega naught is equal to 2. Again, even formula also you can use, no problem. But again, you should know the reason why they are using some different formula here. So, okay. Then we'll calculate what is A naught. What is A naught first? Okay, A naught is 1 by T integration 0 to T x of T dt. 1 by T is pi here. Okay, time period of the signal is pi only. 0 to pi, again only one limit. What is the value of x of T? Vm sin T dt. Vm divided by pi, integration of sin theta is minus cos t divided by pi 0. Okay, again, so finally we'll get 2 Vm divided by pi. Okay, again, this is not the surprising result, because the average value of the half wave rectifier is Vm by pi. Definitely the full wave rectifier is 2 Vm by pi. Okay, there you are having, alternatively you are having the signal, but here continuously you are having the signal. So 2 Vm by pi. Okay, this is the average or DC of full wave rectifier, average or DC value of the full wave rectifier. Next, what is An? An is equal to 2 by T integration 0 to T x of T cos n omega naught T dt. Okay, so here only you have to be a little bit careful. Whatever the omega naught that you are using here, that is 2. Just now here we have calculated. What is omega naught? Omega naught is 2. First fundamental frequency in the representation, the omega naught is 2. Omega is 1, but omega naught is 2. What is T? T is same. T is pi only, but omega naught is 2. Okay. So 2 divided by pi integral 0 to pi. What is xt? Xt is Vm sin t. Vm sin t cos omega naught value is 2. So cos 2nt dt. So 2 pi pi. Again sin theta. Sin a cos b is equal to sin a plus b plus sin a minus b by 2. Okay, so like that, sine 1 plus 2n plus sine 1 minus 2n t divided by 2. Okay, 2 pi pi, again integration of sine is minus cos 1 plus 2n t divided by 1 plus 2n minus cos 1 minus 2n t divided by 1 minus 2n limit 0 to pi. 2 pi pi. Okay, so again, these two we can take outside. This Vm also we can take outside. Okay, these two also we can, these two also we can take outside. So 2 cancel. So you'll be getting Vm by pi. Here you'll be getting Vm by pi. Then apply the limit. Minus cos 1 plus 2n pi divided by 1 plus 2n minus cos 1 minus 2n pi divided by 1 minus 2n plus cos 0 divided by 1 plus 2n plus cos 0 1 plus 1 minus 1 minus 2n Vm by pi. Okay, so cos 0 is 1. Again, this cos 0 is also 1. Again, we can separate these terms. That is 1 minus cos 1 plus 2n into pi divided by 1 plus 2n. Similarly, 1 minus cos 1 minus 2n pi divided by 1 minus 2n. Okay, Vm by pi. 1 minus cos pi is minus 1 whole power 1 plus 2n divided by 1 plus 2n plus 1 minus minus 1 whole power 1 minus 2n divided by 1 minus 2n. So now we have to analyze, when you substitute n is equal to even number or odd number, what is happening to this expression? What is happening to this expression? So when you substitute n is equal to odd number, 2n is even, even plus 1 is odd. So always, again, even if you substitute n is equal to even, 2 into even is even, even plus 1 is odd. Again, whatever may be the n value, either it is even or odd, the term will become like odd. So minus 1 whole power odd number is minus 1 only. Already minus is there, so you will be getting 2. So irrespective of the value of n, let it be even or odd, always this term, entire term is 2. Similarly, here also, if you substitute n is equal to odd number, 2 into odd number is even number, 1 minus even number is odd number. So minus 1 whole power odd is minus 1. Already minus is there, plus 1. So even if you substitute n as an even number, again, you'll be getting same. So the term, this term will also will become like 2. So irrespective of the value of nature of n, always you are getting 2. So that is already Vm by pi. This is 2 divided by 1 plus 2n plus 2 divided by 1 minus 2n. Okay, Vm by pi, 2 minus 4n, 2 plus 4n, 1 minus 4n square. 4 Vm divided by pi into 1 minus 4 n square. Again, this is valid for all n. Valid for all n. Okay, n could be even or odd. Then, how to find out the Bn? How to find out the Bn? So in this expression, when you substitute n is equal to even or odd, always the numerator is odd. So that's why the total term will be 2. Similarly, here also, n is even or odd, the entire term will produce 2. So that's why we are having 2 by 1 plus 2n plus 2 by 1 minus 2n. Then once we simplify, you'll be getting this. That means an value is 4 Vm divided by pi 1 minus 4n square for all value of n. Now let's calculate Bn. Bn is equal to 2 by t 0 to t x of t sine n omega naught t dt 2 by pi 0 to pi, what is x of t? Vm sin t, Vm sin t sin n omega naught. Omega naught value is 2. Okay, so 2nt dt. Then 2vm divided by pi. Okay, integration 0 to pi cos of 1 minus 2n t minus cos 1 plus 2n t divided by 2 dt. These two we can take out. Vm divided by pi. Again, you apply the integration. Integration of cos is sin. Sin 1 minus 2n t divided by 1 minus 2n minus sin 1 plus 2n divided by 1 plus 2n. Apply the limit 0 to pi. Okay, sin pi is always 0 irrespective of this number. Sin pi is always 0. Similarly, here also sin pi is always 0. Again, sin 0 is always 0. So once if you apply this limit, you will be getting always 0 only. Okay, so Vm divided by pi, all are 0. So finally 0. So Bn is 0. Okay, Bn is 0 implies that the given signal is even signal. Okay, whenever Bn is completely 0, the given signal is even signal. Given signal is even signal. Yes, the given signal is even only. The signal is like this. Again, if you see here, the signal is of mirror image with respect to y axis. So again, this signal is also an even signal only. So the given full wave rectifier output is a even signal. Okay, that's why Bn is 0. That's why Bn is 0. So then, what is the final representation? X of t, final representation x of t is equal to a naught summation n 1 to infinite a n cos n omega naught t plus b n sin n omega naught t. Okay, what is a naught value? 2 vm divided by pi plus summation n 1 to infinite. What is a n value? 4 vm divided by pi 1 minus 4n square cos n omega naught t. What is omega naught value? 2. Okay, so cos 2nt. Cos 2nt. Again, we will not have any bn term because bn is completely 0. Okay, so this is the Fourier series representation of the full wave rectifier signal. Okay, so this consists of DC term as well as the BN term, as well as the AN term, because the given signal is even signal. So we are getting DC as well as AN. Thank you.